Hello, my name is Susanne Lundin and I am a PhD student at Karolinska Institutet, Stockholm, Sweden. And I have recently studied the use of emollients and topical glucocorticoids among adolescents with eczema with data from the population-based birth cohort BAMSE. There are two main reasons why I did this study. One is based on my experiences as a clinical nurse working at the Children and Youth Hospital with patients with eczema. And I have often wondered why I met so few adolescents with eczema. The other reason is my experiences working as a clinical research nurse in the BAMSE study. There I met a lot of adolescents with eczema, and many of them seems to have symptoms from the disease, but a high proportion had no contact with the healthcare. I used self-reported data about eczema and treatment, and the severity was assessed with BAMSE severity score called BAMSE. I also used data from the clinical examination that the skin was examined by a trained nurse, and the severity was self-assessed with POEM, the patient-oriented eczema measure. All adolescents answer question about treatment the last week. In addition, I used data from the Swedish prescribed drug register about dispensed topical glucocorticoids the last 12 months. Data from this population-based cohort shows that almost all adolescents used emollients, but only half used topical glucocorticoids with no differences between sexes. Only one out of four with moderate to severe eczema had a potent topical glucocorticoid dispensed, and symptoms of more severe eczema was not associated with increased likelihood to treat with topical glucocorticoids. All this together indicate that adolescents with eczema in the population are undertreated. Therefore, it's important for all healthcare professionals to be aware of the discrepancy between prescribed and dispensed topical glucocorticoid. Healthcare professionals must also ensure that the patient are aware of and understand the goal with the eczema treatment. Thank you.